Hi friends, let us discuss the fifth part of Transformers, losses and efficiency. The topics to be discussed are losses. Under the heading losses, we need to discuss core loss, ohmic loss, stray load loss and dielectric loss. Under the heading of efficiency, we need to see what is the formula for efficiency and then condition for maximum efficiency. Coming to core loss, the core loss is divided into two parts. One is hysteresis loss and eddy current loss. PC is equal to PH plus PE, where PH is the hysteresis loss, which is equal to KH F Vm to the power of X. And eddy current loss, PE is equal to KE F square Vm square, where KH is a proportion constant which depends on volume and the quantity of the core material, of course the units used. Next, KE is the proportion, it's also a proportional constant for eddy current loss, and this also depends on voltage and resistivity of the core material, of course the thickness of laminations and units used. Vm is maximum flux density, F is the frequency of alternating flux. So core loss mainly related to the core of the transformer. It divides into two parts, hysteresis loss and eddy current loss. And so the depends upon the core material, the values of the constants also changes. So obviously the core loss will change. And the next loss is ohmic loss. Ohmic loss means when a transformer is loaded, the ohmic loss occurs. That means ohmic loss or copper loss, which is I square R loss. So there are two resistances in transformer. One is primary winding resistance, and second one is secondary winding resistance. For these things, if current is flowing through primary, it's I square R. The current is flowing through secondary, it's I square. Obviously, I2 square R2. So that's why copper loss is presented if the transformer is loaded. If there is no loading of the transformer, then the copper loss is very less. Obviously, we neglect the same. And coming to other losses, the other losses are stray load loss and dielectric loss. Stray load loss is obviously the eddy current loss only, but this eddy current loss because of leakage flux field, leakage field. That means these leakage field induce some voltage, some eddy currents in conductors, tanks, channels and bolts and other materials of the transformer, then the stray load loss will occur. In coming to dielectric loss, this loss occurs in the insulating materials. That means transformer oil and solid insulation of high voltage transformers. In high voltage transformers, we need to use the transformer oil and solid for insulation purpose, and because of these insulations, the things will come up. Because of these insulations, the dielectric loss will come. Coming to efficiency, the efficiency is defined as output power by input power, which is equal to V2 I2 cos theta 2 divided by V2 I2 cos theta 2 plus EC plus I2 square R E2. That means the output power is the KVA rating, output VA or KVA rating of the transformer into power factor, that's load power factor, divided by that's the output power, and the input power is obviously output power plus losses. So V2 I2 cos theta 2 plus PC plus I2 square RE2, where PC is the core loss and I2 square RE2 is the ohmic loss. Coming to condition for maximum efficiency, it's D efficiency by D I2 equal to 0. That means it's first derivation, derivative of eta with respect to I2, which should be equal to 0 for getting maximum efficiency, and it will be like this. And finally, in the second step, it has taken x by y, derivation of x by y, in the previous formula, and finally it will be equal to 0. So the denominator term should be multiplied with 0, so obviously it will be 0. And in numerator there are two terms, one term minus the other term, so which is equal to 0. So therefore one first term is equal to the second term. Some parts will be cancelled out, v2 cos theta 2 will be cancelled out, and in the next step v2 i2 cos theta 2 will also be cancelled out. And finally it comes as ec is equal to i2 square r v2, which is therefore core loss is equal to ohmic loss. This is the condition for maximum efficiency. Yeah, this ends the topic of losses and efficiency. Thank you so much. If you like the video, please like it. If you have any doubts or if I commit any mistake, please try to post in the comment box. And please share this video and try to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you. Thank you so much.